Have you ever wondered, what is the best number of legs? I mean, probably not. But how many legs a species has is vital to a lifeform's success, and it's time someone figured out which number reigns supreme. So for this entry into the archive, we'll explore every option for leg count that nature makes available, excluding cases of genetic mutation or limb loss. Whether you're reincarnating soon or a worldbuilder looking to improve the realism of an alien lifeform, this is a question you need answered. We'll kick things off by discussing lifeforms with one leg. You might not think any species has a single leg as their default setting, but nature doesn't care what you think. Many clams and oysters use a single muscular limb to drag themselves along, and their gastropod relatives, a group that includes snails and slugs, have a similarly bold approach. Though it might not look like it, the bottom of one of these slimy fellows is actually a single giant foot, which they slowly undulate to move forwards. The only way this even remotely works is because the snails constantly lubricate their undersides with mucus, allowing them to triumph over friction. Although just barely, as most species clock in at a blazing 1 millimeter per second. But if your only method of locomotion was coating your shoes in oil and shuffling your feet, you probably wouldn't get very far either. Many species in this category are herbivores, as anything faster than a leaf might outrun them. Perhaps on another planet, a lifeform could evolve to hop along on their one leg at greater speeds, although the laws of physics mean that any single-limbed species will likely struggle with uneven terrain. Still, any lineage that, when coming onto land, looked at animals with multiple legs and said, "I'm good, thanks," is pretty hardcore. Up next, we have two legs, a unique option with some major advantages and some major disadvantages when it comes to things like keeping your balance. The vast majority of two-legged species on Earth evolved from four-legged ancestors, which means their former front limbs are now free to be used for all kinds of weird stuff. Birds are a massively successful two-legged group whose forelimbs evolved into wings, allowing them to soar through the skies in a move that feels kind of like cheating. They barely even use their legs, it's not fair. Not all birds take the easy route, however. Ostriches and other large flightless birds strut about with us land dwellers, and penguins, well, they don't strut exactly, but they do their best. Instead of wings, penguin forelimbs have evolved into flippers, increasing their speed in the water, but not so much on land. But wings and flippers aren't the only option for what a two-legged animal does with their front limbs. Primates have evolved grabby hands they use in all sorts of inventive ways, like snagging food, swinging from branches, and cleaning their fur or the fur of others. Now, it's worth noting that not all primates are completely loyal to Team Two Legs. Great apes, for example, often switch into a semi-four-legged posture called knuckle walking. In fact, lots of animals only switch to two legs when it's trendy. Bears typically plod around on all fours, but will rear up on their hind legs to climb trees or appear larger. Meerkats switch to two legs when scanning for danger, the added height giving these nervous lookouts a better view. But let's look at the true converts to the two-leg doctrine, humans. Though our stability isn't the best at first, an adult human's sense of balance is on another level. With practice, a human's flexibility on two legs becomes kind of ridiculous. We might start off crawling on our hands and feet, and like primates, we can still move on all fours if we want, but it's nowhere near as fast as switching to a two-legged stance and running full tilt. Free from the burden of supporting our bodies, our front limbs have become advanced tools for interacting with the world, and for showing other animals how cool we are. Across media, lots of aliens have bipedal body plans, mainly because lots of aliens are actors in budget-friendly costumes. That's not to say two-legged life couldn't emerge on other worlds, they just probably wouldn't look like us. In the end, the two-leg setup is a strong contender for the top spot, despite some flaws like back pain. Next, we've got three legs, and right away there's a problem, because no species has three legs, right? Well, it's complicated. The tripod fish is a deep-sea dweller that perches on the sand using three legs derived from elongated fins. Whether or not these fins should be counted as legs is debatable, as it's actually trickier to define what a leg is than you might expect. By most scientific definitions, a leg is any limb used especially for supporting the body and for walking. Strangely enough, under this definition, kangaroos are another animal sometimes placed in the three-leg category, because when they're not hopping around, their tails function as third legs that keep them upright. What counts as a leg is a question that will only get weirder as this video continues. But for now, it's clear that three legs aren't the most popular. Part of this may have to do with the physics of walking, but it could also be because no early land animals came out of the water with three limbs, and in an alternate history, evolution might have taken a stranger path. But for a species afraid of breaking the mold, four legs are a safe choice. When you think land animals on planet Earth, this is probably the number of legs that comes to mind as the default, and for good reason. Structurally, a four-leg setup means stability. The type of stability that lets you grow into a kind of living flagpole if evolutionary pressures demand it. Four legs are also great for off-roading, letting animals push through tough conditions. They allow for an ideal running gait, and it's no accident this category is home to the fastest land mammals. Really, four legs are good for whatever. But it's not just mammals who have gotten in on the action. Reptiles have had four legs since before it was cool. Another four-legged species are kangaroos. Wait, kangaroos are here too? I mean, they do walk on all fours sometimes, but seriously, they move on two legs, three legs, and four legs? I'll allow it. I guess. The only real disadvantage to committing all the way to four legs and no arms is that picking things up becomes a real challenge. Unless you're an elephant, a species which breaks all the rules by turning their snouts into long, muscular appendages. Elephants probably look at other species that had to choose between being able to pick things up and getting really big and just laugh. An elephant's trunk has over 40,000 muscles, more than in the entirety of the human body, which honestly feels like they're rubbing things in a bit. Overall, four legs are a great basic choice, and likely would be no matter the planet. Five legs are far less popular. The category would be pretty barren if it weren't for a group of star-shaped oddities. Most species of starfish possess five limbs that somewhat stretch the definition of a leg, as it's actually the numerous tube-like feet below each limb that allows a starfish to move along the sea floor. Their appendages are sometimes called legs, sometimes called arms, and sometimes called rays, a third unique category created specifically because starfish refuse to be normal. The other candidate for a five-legged animal is the kangaroo. Kangaroos again? I guess they really do sometimes use all five. You know what? No, I don't care that science backs them up on this. Kangaroos are officially disqualified. Moving on to six legs, just kidding. There's another category we don't want to keep waiting. Though easy to overlook because they're close to the ground, many animals have no legs at all. Snakes are probably the most famous group in this category, able to move by using their muscles to push their scales against terrain. While this might sound like a huge pain, snakes and other legless lizards gave up their appendages for good reason, as their limbless bodies are perfectly adapted to slide into burrows and around tight corners in search of prey. Worms are also getting along just fine without legs, moving by contracting and relaxing the segments of their body. Fish also technically qualify as legless animals, navigating the aquatic realm with fins alone, except for rebels like the flying gurnard, which walk along the sea floor using modified pelvic fins. And some marine life like anemones and coral can spend their whole lives in a single spot, feeding on small aquatic organisms and generally living more like plants than animals. Many of these species could be classified as sessile or fixed in one place, and should probably be in their own bonus category. It's easy to judge, but if you could hang out on a rock all day and have food come to you, would you really be in a hurry to go anywhere? Alright, back to six legs, for real this time. It's a category that might not strike you as popular, but is actually the most widespread of all. This is because the majority of insects have six legs, and there are around 10 quintillion insects on planet Earth, scuttling along often unnoticed by the large animals they vastly outnumber. Six legs are incredibly versatile, enabling insects to move while maintaining a supportive tripod at all times. Some species also evolved wings from ancient, gill-like appendages, meaning they didn't even have to trade in a pair of limbs for flight, which seems massively unfair. And with so many limbs to spare, some insects have gotten pretty creative. Praying mantises are a group that have turned their front limbs into grasping appendages while keeping their four back legs on the ground, a body plan that's basically as close as life on Earth gets to a centaur. There are some inventive concepts of intelligent aliens with similar anatomy, which seems like a layout with great theoretical potential. While there are no large six-legged animals on our planet, the unparalleled success of insects suggests that such a body plan might have serious advantages. The seven-leg category has almost no takers, unless you count the seven-arm octopus, which keeps one of its eight tentacles used for fertilization retracted in a sac beneath its right eye. Seems a bit like cheating, but I'll let it slide. Certain starfish also have seven legs, although once again, that depends on your definition. You might have noticed that there's lots of animals with an even number of legs, yet scarcely any with an odd number. This has to do with bilateral symmetry, the tendency of animals' right and left halves to be roughly mirror images. This trend is likely because a bilaterally symmetrical species is faster and more direct than a radially symmetrical species like a starfish, whose lack of a distinct front or back makes moving in a straight line a real challenge. The best chance for an odd-legged organism to hit the big leagues is probably if a radially symmetrical lifeform later evolved bilateral symmetry, which seems to be the origin of the seven-limbed aliens in Arrival. Back to even numbers, eight legs are the domain of insects' cool older siblings, the arachnids. The poster children of this group are spiders and tarantulas, most of whom have turned their eight legs into all-terrain web-climbing machines. Some people find an arachnid's legs overkill, but they might look at us and think we're seriously under-equipped. The other most famous eight-legged contender is the octopus, who typically possess eight multipurpose tentacles that can both carry them across the sea floor and function as arms. Some have argued that the octopus is technically a biped, as they'll sometimes use only two tentacles to move across the sand. This depends on the species, however, and there's a strong case to be made that an octopus's tentacles meets the criteria for both arms and legs, proving that you can't put an octopus in a box, they'll just ooze back out again. Both octopuses and spiders have been observed functioning just fine with missing limbs, because when you have eight legs, you've got enough to spare. The nine-leg category is another unpopular odd-number section, with the closest contenders being the nine-rayed starfish or the exceedingly rare nine-armed octopus, although its extra limb only happens when a severed tentacle regrows as two. But with 10 legs, things really get crazy as we enter the domain of crustaceans. Many species of lobster and shrimp have a full 10 legs, and with that many legs available, things can get weird. Crabs are crustaceans that have gone the centaur route and lifted their front limbs off the ground to use as pinchers. Some crabs have even turned their back legs into flippers to, swim, because when you have 10 limbs to work with, you might as well. As we know, the crab model is a favorite of evolution, as numerous other crustaceans have converted to the way of the crab, creating multiple false crab lineages that jealously copy the crab's winning formula. While more legs aren't always better, the stunning popularity of crustaceans suggests that they're onto something with their high limb count, and that life on other planets might just be a bunch of crabs. Beyond the event horizon of 10 legs, we enter a black hole of ever-increasing digits. Giant deep-sea isopods have a staggering 14 legs. Caterpillars have a rough average of 16 total legs, with six primary limbs in the front and multiple rows of pseudo-feet in the back to help them move their elongated bodies. Centipedes can have anywhere from 16 to over 100 legs. And finally, some millipedes can have an even higher number than that. And the species with the absolute highest number of legs is the Eumillipes Persephone, which has an astonishing 1,300 legs in total. Though an impressive total count, such a number is only needed to help the species push through the soil deep below the ground, and would be an absurdly impractical number for the vast majority of life on Earth. So, what's the answer? Well, it depends. And yes, I know that's not the most fun answer, but I promise it's the one that's accurate. There are some standouts, but as easy as it would be to arbitrarily assign 2 legs, or 6 legs, or 10 legs as the winner, it would be ignoring the complexity of nature. If there is one thing we've learned, though, it's that nature shows an astonishing amount of variability when it comes to leg numbers. So should you ever design a life form, know that you have a lot of creative freedom in terms of total limbs. In the end, perhaps we should strive to appreciate the leg counts of all animals. Except for kangaroos. And speaking of numbers, I'd like to thank all my subscribers for bringing Curious Archive past the 500,000 milestone, plus a little extra. That's over 498,000 more people than the Eumillipedes has legs, which is absolutely astounding to me. I really can't express my gratitude enough to every one of you. This channel wouldn't be possible without your continued support. Thank you all so much for watching. And if you're new to the channel, this is the part where I say if you enjoyed this entry, you can lend your support by liking, subscribing, and hitting the notification icon to stay up to date on all things curious. See you in the next video.